My shirt doesn't say that today. Donna, thank you. Oh, this is, how many bags? 20 singles. These are the Frito and the Lay ones, our snackers that we eat. Oh, and this one's different. This is 20 individual ones, too, and these are Ruffles. Oh, these are Ruffles and Cheese Puffs ones. Thank you, Donna. I've often said I wonder what it would look like if we had a pile of all of these that we've gone through. It would be quite amazing, I'm sure. Oh, wow. So this is the volunteer yummy one. Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. I will help with that one. And, Slim Jims. And I got a feeling this is probably supposed to be divided between Elizabeth and Jimmy. They're the big stick eaters like that. And then, what is this one? Oh, Oreo, Nutter Butter, and Chips Ahoy. How many is in here? There's 12 of them in here. Thanks, Donna. You got our, you're hitting all of our favorites. Oh, this is different. And two containers of gum. Are these gum? Gum. Sugar-free gum. Yes. That's so very nice. Thank you, Donna. That's really nice. That's different. And we also have Capri juice. These are 100% juice. I didn't know Capri made 100% juice. That's good. That's good. Keep our volunteers healthy, huh? There's four of these. So, Donna, I thank you. Let me run these over, and then I'll come back and open that one there again.
Are you doing okay?
Mary won't be in tonight because Archibald won. So Barb is Mary tonight. Barb is always super willing to come in and help, and I always appreciate her. Always, Barb.
I like it.
Yeah, I'm glad.
I see
they're in juice. And this box is also from Donna. Donna, thank you. Mary writes, I don't know what her actual title is there, but she does a lot for that newspaper. And Archibald is a small town, but it's a really a nice, friendly town. I've always liked Archibald. Yep, this is from Donna J.B. Oh, so the other one was a volunteer box. This one is the kitty box. Yes. Wow. This is especially what I use in the mornings for breakfast. These are the Whiskas pouches. There's one. Whoops-a-daisy. Get in there. Two. Three. Four. Five. And then there's the big size of Whiskas pouches. So this is like 5, 6, 7, actually, that would be like. And then there's a Frisky pouches, too. So these are the ones we keep up top and down below, and I think everybody uses these. And I also use these for those special 12 or 13 plates that I make in the morning. Donna, I appreciate this so much. Yeah, you are a very good taker care of our tummies and the kitties' tummies. Yeah, appreciate it. And so the kitties don't get in these. I'm going to, boy. If I drop these, I hope it's off camera. Okay. What are you going to do, Nemo? Boop, boop, ba-doop. This box, oh, you can't see down there. This box is, this is from Donna. This is Donna night so far. We have a scratcher pad. And we try to keep you all hopping. Do you remember that knife that I misplaced the other night? I did find it, but now I misplaced the one tonight. Sorry, Zelda. I'll find it. It's here. You can join me today, Miss. These are fun. The kitties just love these. I'm going to put this one in. With Clarissa. Oh, they're out right now, aren't they? Clarissa and her gang's been out all day. Yeah, that's what has tied me up today. All the baths we've been doing, and I'll explain that in a little bit. These are fun. The cats love these. The scratching pads. Hey, guys. Do you want this? Yeah. We'll take it. And what's this one? Okay, Zelda, you're sitting on a book. Oh. Donna, this is wonderful. Oops. Oops. Okay. This is it's called Wings of Encouragement. But the poems are by Helen Steiner Rice, wonderful author. And the paintings are by John A. Ruthven. And it looks like there's lots of chapters. Oh, that's really nice. Nothing to tomorrow morning. No, you're not a person.
I'll barely see his best, so I think you have to do it.
What to do? Oh, no. Folks, I am so sorry. I'm trying to fix something, so hang on, please.
I'm sorry.
that in the living room?
In the dining room garden. I am so, so sorry, everybody. It's kind of crazy here. I am really sorry. But this book is all on wings of encouragement. There's one on wisdom, but everything is centered around birds. Tenderness, the robin. Tenderness of friendship, and it's the robins. Believe, and it's a house wren. The beauty of spring, and it's an indigo bunting, one of my favorites. Adversity can distress us or bless us. These are the red-headed woodpeckers. One more. Oh, wings of encouragement. It's a bobwhite quail. Donna, thank you, thank you, thank you. I love this, and I will read this and enjoy this very much. I appreciate it. Actually, I will probably read a few pages tonight, even. Okay, my baby girl, I'm going to set you right here. Okay. And this box, this is Donna's night. Donna, this is your night. Also, just me, if you could also put that we had two boxes of, two baits of that wonderful precious litter. They're 40 pounds. And I've got those in the room already where we'll use those probably on Sunday. So thank you. And so this is, what are you doing with that?
I lost my keys from right here.
Uh-oh.
I have several found in my pocket, and I have bolts and wrenches and screws.
What do they look like? Keys purple, to the house? Or?
The truck. Purple flat keychain, big okay. Black key, that is keys.
Okay, were you in the house at all? Okay. I'll finish this box.
Don't worry, no, if you see it over the weekend, this.
Okay. Do you have another set? Okay. You were mostly out at the fence, right?
Yeah, I looked where I put all the tools away.
Okay.
I do remember them having them out.
Okay. At lunch?
And that's what they're on our desk earlier.
Okay. When I get done, Jimmy, I'll run out and look around too. Oh, the kitties are playing with that scratch board already. This is for... Well, the greenies for the kitties, tempting tuna flavor. We'll try that maybe tonight. But also to help us with all of the baby making rules and all the babies, which there will be more. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 4, 6. There's 3 turkeys, 3 ocean whitefish, and they're all for the kitties. And Donna, I very much appreciate this. Very, very much. Let me come around. I put these in the house because we rotate, so. I always feel funny taking them in the house, but you guys know what we're doing. Feeling Zelda.
You see, Zelda's in a box, so you can just see her ears over the top. There's something behind the table. I can't roll it back anymore. Sorry. Did I get him?
Short
of the P and who is going to do it work.
three different kinds of greenies. They have tuna and chicken and catnip flavor. I think catnip flavor needs to be used tonight. Yep. Lisa, I think somehow or another we need to get a golden paintbrush and give you.
Yeah, I want to check it too on what I have painted, like the trim.
Uh-huh.
Probably needs 2 coats.
Okay.
In places.
Okay. Yeah. Trucker didn't come in it.
I know.
Gone again, thank you. Do you want to throw that in here?
Oh, I will see you all tomorrow.
Right.
Thank you. Okay, Nemo. Poo-poo, poo-doo. Yep. I wonder how Donna planned this. This is Donna. Donna JB. Because a lot of times when people... Uh-oh. Oh. A lot of times when people send multiple boxes, they never get here at the same time. Never. So, Donna, thank you.
Yeah, would you? Because I might just lose everything tonight.
Paper towels. This is on our need list. Okay. You stay right there. You stay there. We'll dump these out. Stay there, Zelda. Oops. Donna is wonderful, and she will be okay. There are 30 rolls of paper towels. Just in time for Tabitha's birthday. Which, does she have one up there?
She does. Well, part of one.
There is one?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, she's okay yet for a little while. Yeah, so Donna, thank you. A box and a box. And... Not only did we get paper towels out of that, but we'll make a little fun box for the kitties out of that. So, Donna, you are appreciated. And then I have a couple updates for you, too. Let me take this over here.
Where are
you going? Like Jimmy's office, and then tomorrow we'll take it out to the shed. Thank you. Hey. What's going on? 3 cats chasing each other. Not good. Goodness. Yeah, Tabitha. Let me get my paper. Rachel, you weren't involved in that, I hope. Oh my goodness. Clarissa's kitties just are, they just come everywhere. They're so sweet. And Clarissa is also equally wonderful. She's just really a nice cat. Tabitha, just for an FYI. What are you doing, baby girl? Tabitha arrived here when she was only 5 weeks old. And she arrived here on 6/29/2012. Can you believe that? Oh, brother. Oh, sorry, I messed up my things. Just a minute, I gotta fix it. Oh, geez, Jackie.
Baby.
So, Tabitha came on 5/20 or 6/29/12. So she's 3 years old, and she is.
What are you doing?
This is just not my night. I don't know what that is, but I'm sure it's not something I'm supposed to be sitting on.
Oh.
So Tabitha's 3 years old. You know, it kind of worries me sometimes, you know, like when we find a home for somebody who's been here for a little while, how they will do leaving, you know, when their whole entire life has been here. But we have to hope that a home is out there for her, and we have to hope that it will be a good home for her. So, yeah, she arrived here when she was just weeks old.
She went to the storm drains.
No. She came in with a couple other kitties, and we named them all horse stuff. Derby, I think Derby was one. I thought maybe
or something.
Who's going on? So we wish Tabitha a happy birthday, and I know I've fed her extra snacks a couple times today. And we do have we do have two cards here we should do. Yeah, I would imagine Tabitha's been doing her rolling of the paper towels for, a year and a half or so? I'm not sure. This is from Clark. We always know it's from Clark. And it's happy birthday, Seymour. Oh, which is 2 more days. Well, we'll go ahead and open that since I have it open. Birthday pop star. Oh. Whoa, Seymour Riggs.
Uh-huh.
He gets 4 of the 5 famous dollar bills. How'd you do that? I wonder if Clark knew he did this. You're everyone's idol. Happy birthday, birthday boy. Have a great birthday, Seymour. Clark, Jesse, and the rest of the game. Wow.
Messy Jesse Badhead.
Yeah, Messy Bessie.
Messy
Jesse
Badhead.
Jesse, or Clark, you better talk to your mom and dad and make sure that they knew you took a 20 instead of a 5 for Seymour's birthday. Okay, yeah, Clark can't read on that one. Thank you, Clark. He's such a good kitty, and they have two good kitty cats. We have people in today that have adopted from us before. It's been kind of fun to listen to their stories, see pictures. It makes me feel good. And this is a donation from Susan C. And Susan C. is a good friend of FFRC. Susan, thank you very, very much. I appreciate it. So Jesse, our Jesse Senior, is back. She had a full mouth extraction. You know, when we were going around, when Dr. Darcy and I, like 2 times ago, in April was that, and was doing all the checks on the dentals. Jesse wasn't actually due for a physical at that time, so we didn't do her. And then during that time, I had noticed that she had been chewing a little carefully. So I had her check last time, and yeah, she definitely needed it. We found her.
Yes, I want to talk to you about her.
Okay, can you hang on? You guys are good.
I just told my wife, I said, hey, you're going to have to wait for
down to the right.
Okay, so Jesse's good. Jesse will be up here in a little bit to spend the night. Kitties are all going good. We've been working on, and I did talk to the morning crew this morning. We got a phone call a few days ago about, wait a minute. Oh. We got a phone call a few days ago about, the two kitties, India and Michaela, the little gray and the little black one. We got a phone call that the third kitty in that litter, which stayed with the rescue where they were being raised at, came up with some fungus. Or as you know, that is, that is ringworm. And so our guys all look really good, other than I did notice one of the black kitties had a little bit right here that it looked a little suspicious. So if you have been around us when we work with ringworm, we don't fool around with it. We stop it like now. So I did seven or eight baths this morning, and then this afternoon Sonia helped me and we did 8 more in the back. So we have a few more to do back there. But we also immediately started.
It's like the outtakes from movies and planes are in.
We start the Fulvasun. And that's that stuff that I always say is the $1,000 treatment, because we will treat this for several weeks. We just do it. It's just part of what we have to do. And I just can't begrudge the pills or anything, because I learned the hard way that if you wait and just treat maybe one here and one here and one here, you'll end up with everybody anyhow. So we don't do that. We treat all across the board. Everybody gets it. It's done. It's over with. No big deal. So we have caught it at the extremely early time, and we're fine on it. Yeah, that was a leaf blower to add to everything else that's been going on here today. Got another email from, no, there's no email. I wish there was. Wouldn't that be cool? Ringworm collar. Pop them out, put them on. Be a whole lot cheaper, I'm sure. Yeah, Hensley might be hungry if he's crying. He eats in the bottom over there in that pen. And he likes appetizers. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, you guys had the ear hairs weed-whacked. So I also had some, our policy here, folks, is if anybody cannot keep any of our cats, that we want them to come back here. Sometimes it's hard to understand, but it doesn't matter what the reason is. You've all heard me say it at adoptions. Good reason, bad reason, or no reason. If you can't keep up with the kitty that you're adopting from here, we want them back. Doesn't matter if it's 2 days, 20 years, whatever reason, for whatever, we will take them back. So we've had a wonderful, wonderful person has adopted a few cats of ours, and 5 of them to be exact. And unfortunately, she has come upon some hard health issues where she cannot safely keep the cats anymore. She's doing the right thing. She emailed me, wanted to know what I wanted her to do. She could either try there, she said, to find homes, or they could be returned. And of course, our thing is we want them back here. So they are in South Carolina, so it's from here to there, it's a 10-hour drive, no stop. So obviously this will be a 2-day thing. So we have a bit of time to work with this. There goes the drone again. We have a little bit of time to work this all out. It's a lot of you who've been here with us for a couple years will know these names. It's Cubby. Cubby was one of our Chicago kitties. Hark. Hark was tossed out of the car, front left leg, the radial nerve was severed, and we did do a front left leg amputation. Remember, she had to have her lip sutured as well. Marky and one of the other Arkies, Barky and Barky, and these were, so sorry for all that noise. These two kitties, amongst the other litter mates, were actually ended up being turned into Dr. P's office. These were the kitties that, if they didn't take them, the guy said, fine, you don't take them, we're going to drown them. So they did take them, and then we ended up taking the litter. And then Mary Kay, who was another Chicago 5 kitty. Yeah, so two of the Chicago 5 kitties, two of the Arky groups. Is that right? And the one that was thrown out of the car. These, Cubby, just to remind you, was a black tiger. Hark is a black tiger. Marky is a brown tiger. Barky is a gray and black tiger. And Mary Kay is a brown tiger with kind of some spots on her. So, Cubby, Hark, Marky, Barky, and Mary Kay. There you go. Sam Cat has it. So, they're in South Carolina. We'll work out something to get them back here. But the owner, the mom, loves these cats with a passion. It's just unfortunate that she's fallen upon some health issues that she can't keep them. Their birthdays, most of them are in like the fall of 2013. So they will be 2 years old. So they're adult cats. They're all about a year and a half right now. Yeah. She came back and she came and adopted the three. While she was here, she fell in love with those other two. And Angie and Bill flew out with them to give them to her. I do too, like that policy, Piper Joe. Yep. I will tell her that, Pablo. That is so very sweet. Very, very sweet. I will tell her that. Yep. And that's right, Dutchie. Yep. It's not just that we're being given our 5 kitties back, but I feel sorry for her. Yeah. It is hard. It is very hard to give them up like that. Yep. We all know. Okay. Any other questions?
What's the door closed for? What's going on?
Yeah, it would be hard. Ahimsa, well, I was quite honestly, I was worried about her this morning. Couldn't get her to eat anything, nothing at all. I syringed better, wiped her off again, brushed her out, made her feel better. Then late morning, she did eat a nice handful of Snackers. And again this morning later, she ate a big handful of Snackers, and then this afternoon later she ate 3 jars of baby food for Sonia. Sonia is not allowed to leave without her being a better eater. So she just loves Sonia. But you know, she's moseying around a little bit more, and I think she looks, yeah, her eyes look bright, alert. Yeah, I think she's doing better. I have not heard again about Ratchet. Not again recently. So you know, sometimes I hear once, sometimes I hear twice. any new adoptions? I don't have any currently because this is the time of year when the adults that we have here are mostly the ones that we are keeping, other than like 8 or 10 of them are up for adoption, but then we have a lot of babies, and we do have holds on some of the babies. We waited a little while, as we usually do, until they're a little bit bigger, and we do have some holds on them. Thank you, Sonia, for your hard work with the HIMSA.
Oh, you're welcome.
You have the magic touch, too. You know, she might be depressed, but you know, the last two days before the babies passed away, she really pulled herself away from the kitties. She was so sick. Yeah. Well, I understand Beth's birthday party is going to be, what we're going to do here is show the yummy cake. And I'm supposed to do that after breakfast is all done. So, and I will tell you this too. Because of the many, many, many graduations this weekend, the cakes are hard to get. So this cake is going to be super duper fresh because it's actually being picked up tomorrow morning. It's not here yet. So as soon as it comes in the door, we will show it and start it. There was definitely a reason for Sonia's trip, other than we love to have her, but for him, so. Okay, not sure if I missed anything. Coralie needs a snack or she will be hungry. Grumpy.
And no one wants that.
No.
You're hungry.
Okay, well, we'll bring Jessie up here probably about 7 o'clock. And I think she'll be fine. We'll just go ahead and let her down. But they did a full mouth extraction on her. So we've been giving her the antibiotics that we do, the clindamycin. And we will continue that for 5 more days. We say thank you for filling in for Mary.
Oh, you're welcome.
Yeah. See the inky or an orange baby? I'll ask Sonia if she can bring one up. Okay. Thanks, Connie. Okay. Yep, she will get pain meds too, you betcha. Yep, but I'm very, very careful. I just put it inside her lip and she'll get it. My kitty's not doing very good. Zertle is very sick. Good, I'm glad, Min Kitty. Zertle was fine when we left Tuesday. I noticed we got back later Wednesday. I noticed, gosh, is that just yesterday morning? Today's Friday.
You got home Wednesday night.
Wednesday night. Thursday morning, she was, I noticed when she came out for breakfast. Oh, no, I noticed she did not come out for breakfast, so I went and looked for her, and she wasn't too perky. And so, you know, I just covered, she wanted under the blankie, so I covered her up, and I checked on her all day yesterday, and I was not aware, I guess, how really bad she was until this morning. And she got really, really, really sick really, really fast. Her blood sugar's up to over 700, and she has pancreatitis, and her kidneys are very high, and her white blood cell count is high, and her red blood cell is very low. So she has multiple things going on. But, you know, it just hits home again how their bodies want to heal, and they are a creature of hiding their symptoms. Now, I knew last night she wasn't feeling very good, but I knew this morning she was in big trouble. And you guys know me well enough to know that I'm watching my babies, all of them, like a hawk. And my red flags did not go out yesterday, but they sure did this morning. So she's there at the hospital. They're going to stay late with her tonight. Somebody's going to be early and then in the morning. Dr. Darcy's going to call me tonight. I sent her there with her little sweater on. They got a heater under her. So she'll stay warm. She is, I think she's like five. I believe she's five. At this point, she, AHIMSA, hasn't been contagious for a few days. She was during the fever stage, but not now. Yeah, and you know, and like Zertl, chances are things were showing up before that, but they are great masqueraders. Thank you. That might be her.
Come on. There might be one more baby out someplace. Oh, yes, there is. Come on. AJ, mommy wants you.
AJ, the adventurer.
Come on, baby girl. Boy. Oh, my goodness, you might need to be upside down to get you. Here's AJ. He's going into the room. Mama says, come in here now. Night, night.
Streetlights are coming on. Time to go home, buddy.
Are you looking for Jackie?
Yes.
In the house?
Yes.
On the phone?
No. Hey. How's the phone?
How's the fire, boys?
That one was Luke, so don't blame me.
Was there just one fire?
Yeah.
Okay.
It must have, like, it wasn't in front of me. I couldn't see it.
It probably, caught all the leaves under the shed. We're just, oh, God.
Yep.
Did you hear about that?
I didn't hear the story. I just heard smoke.
Was that your sister?
Yeah.
Here, Jerry, this is from you.
Thanks, Sonia. This is a famous mod.
Dude says that Pen Life agrees with him. Mm-hmm. Him says out of her bed, dude's decided, yeah, maybe I'll go eat it.
Yes.
looking pretty chillax there. Sorry, I know it's hard to angle it here so that it looks right. Oh, there, that's kind of good, I guess. Silly dude.
So, yeah, we almost had a fire tonight. We had smoke coming out from underneath one of our sheds. And see, Jimmy was meant to have lost his keys because he's the one who was looking around for his keys and noticed it. So all is fine, but it has been a crazy day. Crazy day. Oh, Mary Mort, Emery is just fine. We do it as a precaution to everybody. Yeah, the kitties are fine. Nobody's got it back there. Absolutely not. No, nope. But we do it as a precautionary thing. Yeah, well, and I guess I should own up why that happened. Oh gosh, it's kind of funny in a way. Thank you, Richard. You know, we have those gigantic cottonwood trees, and they are extremely, extremely heavy with the cottonwood fuzzies. And a friend of mine told me that they rake a... Why not? Oh, my gosh. That they rake them up, all the fuzzies, and then they just light it, and it poofs, and it's all gone in a second. So... I've been all week when I see piles of, you know, big fluffy piles of cottonwood here, I've been putting the fire starter on it, and it just poofs, and they're all gone. It's gone, and I've been doing that all week, just having fun, poofing everything. Well, the boys were doing it, and I told them they could do that to help me out, because there's literally millions and millions and millions and millions of cottonwood fluffies all around here. Our cottonwood grove that we have is, they're gigantic trees, and they're everywhere. I mean, we get it where sometimes they stacks up 1-2 feet high. And so the boys was going around, and they had a pile there by the shed, and they lit it, not thinking that the sheds are raised up off the ground about 6 inches, and it's full of dry leaves under there. And the dry leaves caught on fire. So see, Jimmy came to looking for his keys, and he was down at the big red barn looking, and he noticed the smoke coming out from under there. So he used 2 fire extinguishers on it. Yeah, we could have had a big fire. Yeah, it runs like it sure does. It just poofs. Yeah, so if you do it, have a bucket of water beside you.
You should call Scott out there. Jerry, this is Scott. My sister's on right now.
Oh, is she? Oh, yeah, this is Scott. We love him. Oh, yeah, these cottonwoods that we have here, I don't know how many there are out there, but they're massive. And I got to get something for the boys.
I sure do wish Scott could find a good home. I would take him in a minute if I could. He's a good boy. He's a good player. He's the one that flies. Yes, you are. You're the one that flies. Yep. 2 days in a row, I got in 10,000 steps. You got doity eyes. Here's Jesse. You want to get down?
Yes, okay. Good boy. Our girl.
Okay, let's go. My sister says thank you.
Oh, awesome. week. I have to run into town for a little bit, but I will be back later on to see who's around and chit chat. Oh, the cottonwood.
Thank you.
Thank you. Car. Car. Just in there if you need anything, okay? Okay, yeah. You can't run away very easy, can I? I'll be out, I'm sure.
not cool enough? Is that what you're saying?
You can turn down one.
Okay, all right.
Thank you. Uh-huh. What's your normal at night when I leave?
Waddle, you say, Brandon?
you. Who's that? Kiara, what was your first name?
The what?
What's next to?
Well, the thing that is, like, if you do, say, 76, it's enough to get the humidity out. Mm-hmm. You know, it doesn't make it cold that it's whatever, it just gets the humidity out.
Thank you.